So I'm going to turn you loose and let you do that thing, okay? You think you can do that?
Yeah, I can do it.
All right, then as soon as you do that, we're going to talk. Hang on a minute, let me ask. Mr. Bryan, you got anything you'll say real quick before we get loud? Here we go.
Hate to win them like that, guys. Greg done a good job, but I just don't know if it was right or not, and I had to do it. Thank you.
That's racing. You ain't got a whistle, do it.
Boogity, 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 boogity.
All right. Look here.
All right, Darrell Watson, let's rock and roll. On the pole in the night is Dustin Carver on the outside of 52D. That's Mark Douglas. Looks like Carver gets a good bite coming out of two, but on the outside of the 52D, Mark Douglas will pick up the lead going down in turn three on the first of 41 laps at the mountain. Also in the 97 of Bobby Giffen, he drags her underneath on the berm, trying to look for third underneath the 22 of Mike, the milkman Weeks. Weeks picks up the bite coming out of turn two and will run a soft third position. Looking down the tracks of the 9-car Dusty Carver, but in the front is the 52D of Mark Douglas with a 6-car length lead, this time under the flag stand. Two laps, 39 to go. Looks like the posse is back. The C5 of David Crabtree up underneath the 007 of Roger Best looking for fifth place. Up front, it's the 52, and here comes the 9-car of Dusty Carver. And underneath, it's the double deuce of Mike Weeks, the milkman, up to second. And running in fourth is still the 97 of Bobby Giffen, 007 Roger Best. The race is up front, race fans, $3,000 on the line. Who's it going to be? We've got 38 laps to go before we know. 52D of Mark Douglas, the double deuce of Mike Weeks, the 9-car of Dusty Carver. The front three, the only one not to win so far this year, is the one on the point, 52D of Mark Douglas. But here comes the double deuce of Mike Weeks. He comes underneath the 52D looking for the lead in turn three. But Douglas slams the door and gets a good bite coming out of four, and angles her down with the 1-car length lead at the flag stand. Racing action throughout the entire field. Your top five is Douglas, Weeks, Carver, Giffen, and Roger Best. The 17 car wide runs up a little high coming out of turn two, opens up the position for the 12 of Tony Scripture, a fine run for the 12. The veteran and two-time track champion, the 29 of Jason Wilson, eyeballs the C5 of Crabtree for six. Looks like already it's going to be lap traffic for the 52D of Mark Douglas and the double deuce of the milkman Mike Weeks. Putting on one heck of a show this time by 34 laps to go in this 41 lap feature for $3,000. Lap traffic comes down to the inside berm and allows the front runners to clear coming down the front straightaway. Carver now being hounded by the 97 of Bobby Giffen, but a lap car gets in between Giffen and Carver, allowing Carver to stretch out a 6-car length lead. Meanwhile, up front, it is still the 52D of Mark Douglas, absolutely on a string, as well as the double deuce of Mike Fifthman Weeks. Douglas bobbles just a little bit coming out of turn two, allowing Weeks to sneak up under one fender, but the horsepower of the 52D does pull away. This time by, it will be 31 more laps. Modified four-cylinder, modified fours, you need to be getting on the racetrack. It's not going to take long for these supers. They are absolutely flying here at the mountain on this beautiful spring evening. For $3,000, we are going to have one heck of a race for the lead. Underneath, coming out of turn two is the double deuce of Mike Weeks. He picks up the position on the 52D, your new leader. Coming up on lap traffic, he's going to get in both of their ways. But it's the new leader, the milkman, Mike Weeks, trying to race for $3,000. These race fans, this place is absolutely packed on this military law enforcement fan appreciation night at the mountain. Not a seat in the house to witness this $3,000 giveaway on behalf of Kevin Coffey and the fine staff bringing back this beautiful racing facility for events like this and a lot more to come in a couple of weeks. The Thunder Series, as the position spread out just a little bit, still on the point. It's the milkman, Mike Weeks. Fine run for the young man, Dusty Carver. He's been the top three all year long. Once again tonight, he's running third. and Mike Weeks works his way around yet another lap car. Coming up on another group of lap cars this time by, it's Mike Weeks. 25 laps remaining in this super late model mountain feature race. The legend, Zeke Buchanan, in the three car, slams the inside retaining wall, bringing out a caution. It appears that the three car, Zeke Buchanan, got an late model mountain feature race, 3,000. Race fans, as these race cars work their way around, next time by, 25 more laps. We're proud to have on hand one of our Brian Morlock and Matt Locke decals helping beautify all these race cars, all the signage here in turn 3 and 4, 1 and 2, and on the main straightaway right here. So once again, also one of his checks is going to be presented to tonight's feature winner, a gorgeous $3,000 check. 41 years of racing experience. Thank you very much, Brian Morlock and Matt Locke decals. Let's rock and roll. It's the 29 of Jason Welshon handling the 007 of Roger Bass for fifth place up front, running single file. Mike Weeks, Mark Douglas, Dusty Carver, and Bobby Gibbon. Still up front this time by, it's going to be Mike Weeks with 23 laps remaining. Mike Weeks appears to be your fastest car on the point, and looks like maybe the second fastest car is the 97 of Bobby Gibson. Just cannot get underneath the third place car of Dusty Carver. Halfway home, 20 more laps for the 22 of Mike Weeks coming up on lap traffic. The 15 of Standridge bobbles just a little bit coming out of turn 2, but it will hear way to the leader, Mike Weeks. Roger Benson, the 007, giving 97 Bobby Giffen a run for fourth place. They're running side by side, running down the back straightaway. And also it appears like the 9 car Dusty Carver may be gaining a little bit on the 52D of Mark Douglas. Giffen does fight him off and maintains a 2-car length lead over Roger Bass for fourth. Up front, it's Mike Weeks pulling away with a 12-car length lead over the second-place runner, the 52D, though, Mark Douglas. And your pole sitter in the 9 car now runs third. That's Dusty Carver. The battle once again appears to be for fourth between Big Daddy Bobby Giffen and the 97 007 of Roger Best. But up front, once again, it's the Milkman Mike Weeks maintains a 12-car length lead over second-place runner Mark Douglas. Mm-hmm. The 00, Kelvin White, looks like his motor expires and he will exit the race coming in the pits in turn four. Comes the double do. It's the milkman this time by. He will have 12 laps remaining. That much closer to $3,000. Not bad for second place. Who's it going to be battling for the $1,400? Is it the 52D of Mark Douglas or the 9 car of Dusty Carver? Still battling back here for fourth is Bobby Giffen. Coming up on lap traffic once again, it's the second place runner in the 52D, it's Mark Douglas. He will pull away and try to chase down the leader, Mike Weeks. Ten laps remaining in the first big giveaway at the Mountain. $3,000 to the winner. Nine more laps, who's it going to be? Coming out of turn four, this time by, we have 7 laps remaining in this 41-lap feature race. Looks like some of the lap traffic's getting tangled up a little bit. I hope they sort themselves out because the leader's coming in a hurry, diving out of turn four. We have a mess coming out of turn four. We have lap traffic along with the leaders. In the 29 is Jason Wilson trying to manipulate his way through some lap traffic. And this very well could cause an issue with the double deuce because he's right on their tail. We have side-by-side racing for position and trying to move out of the way of lap cars going into turn three. It looks like the leader, Mike Weeks, will drive down low coming out of the berm and will maintain his 14-car length lead over the 52D of Mark Douglas. 4 laps remaining. Three more laps for the milkman. Bobby Giffen in the 97, 007 Roger Best have been racing absolutely all night trying to hold down fourth place. That might be the area to look at here if you're in your vehicle over into your parking or join us in the main grandstand. The race for fourth is side by side. This time by, the double deuce of Mike Weeks will head down the back straightaway and come around 3 and 4, white flag this time by. He has a comfortable 10-car length lead over second place runner Mark Douglas in the 52D, and he tries to hold off the third place runner Dusty Carver. White flag. Weeks picks her up and puts her down, coming out of turn two, runs a beautiful line into three, and sorts her up into turn four, and stomps on the throttle, and here he comes 300 feet away from $3,000 in the 22. It's the milkman, Mike Weeks. And running a fine show to collect $1,400 in the 52D is Mark Douglas in a fine run in the 9 car. Rookie driver down here at the Mountain is Dusty Carver, and starting in the top 5 and finishing 4th in the 97, Bobby Giffen. 0007 is Roger Best. Congratulations to the milkman, Mike Weeks. Thank you. iRace fans as the Milkman Mike Weeks, second feature win in 2007, our first two-time feature winner in the Super Late Models. Congratulations, Milkman, as he works his way onto Chris Breeden's victory lane and visits with three Willem photos, Mike Knuckles, to get that gorgeous photo. We plan to visit with the Milkman, and hopefully later tonight for the podcasting, if we can, the folks in the 52D garage, we might want to have Mark Douglas as well as the Milkman join us tonight. Up next in the Modified 4 feature race. This is a 15-lap event starting on the pole in the 47, Rusty Knox. On